The next contest is sanctioned by the National Wrestling Alliance and is set for one fall. Introducing first, he'll be accompanied to the ring by his tag team partner, the former Anthony Andrews, representing tradition. From Gullah Island, one half of the NWA Georgia Tag Team Champions, Marvelous Michael Stevens!
You are my home, we will never, never, never be apart. Oh, we are complaining. We're just friends, what are you saying? Said there's another rhythm right in my eyes. My first love broke my heart for the first time. And I was like, baby, 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 oh, baby, 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 oh, baby, 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 oh, thought you'd always be mine, mine. Baby, 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 oh, baby, 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 oh, baby, 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 oh, thought you'd always be mine.
And his opponent, he'll be accompanied to the ring by the Black Widow and his one half of the tag team known as Bloodsport Trauma. From somewhere between heaven and hell, weighing 420 pounds, this is Pain!
Big Chad here, our second of our matchup here involving the BFFs this evening here. We saw Adorable Anthony victorious by a count out over Fridaddy earlier tonight, and he is at ringside to cheer on his partner, Marvelous Michael Stevens, taking on the Monster Pain. And let's see what Michael Stevens has to say for himself.
Oh my gosh!
Wow!
Payne not real interested in what Michael Stevens had to say here this evening. Showing great patience was one Payne waiting for his opportunity to knock some teeth loose. Michael Stevens is out of the ring here. The matchup has started. The bell is rung. Radar Martin with a count out here at this point. Payne heading outside the ring now, going after Michael Stevens. Adorable Anthony at ringside, consoling his partner here. Payne's partner, Bill the Butcher, has a title matchup with Tyson Dean here later this evening. That is why he is not at ringside. And obviously you see Kurt Kilgore is not here at ringside.
Oh!
Wow!
Nearly took
his head
off.
Huge clothesline.
Man.
An incredible, that almost sounded like a chop. But it was a clothesline, huge skin-on-skin hitting that chest of Michael Stevens. And he is in la-la land, folks, right over that second turnbuckle. And Payne is, there is no wrestling-only rules here for this matchup, as we can tell already. And Payne is going to be taking advantage of that.
Exactly. That's his end just round.
Boots to the stomach from Michael Stevens. Headbutt there. Yeah, no, it's not going to end up well.
Not even phase is the big
man. He didn't even break his hair. Michael Stevens yelling at the fans here on the outside, and Payne has left the ring once again. A shot for Adorable Anthony as Payne goes after Michael Stevens. Michael Stevens into the side barricade here. Let's see if we can get the camera angle there. Oh, looks like he's getting him in the shot there. Barricade looks like it may be loose there. Michael Stevens asking Radar Martin to count faster. Trying to get a 10 count there. Maybe another count out.
I don't know if that works
this evening. No, I don't believe you get him to count faster. Radar Martin, senior official here in NW Atlanta, cannot be harassed into doing something like that. That is for sure. Really sure what's happening here. Michael Stevens asking the referee to count fast. Michael thought he had the matchup won here as he was counting to 10. Radar Martin wasn't, as he's being constantly distracted by the Black Widow here at ringside. Radar Martin lost track of the count. Michael Stevens here with a forearm right across the face, going for a pinfall attempt. And looks like, yeah, Payne is under the ropes. So referee Radar Martin stopped the count. He was going for a pinfall attempt there. Radar got down to make that count. Realized Payne's leg was under the rope, and that stopped the count there. So that's what happened with that pinfall. Even though it looked like Payne, you know, didn't kick out because he knew his leg was under the ropes.
Right.
Payne with a chop right in the chest of Michael Stevens. If you could see it, it certainly would be red. That is for sure. Rake to the eyes there. Radar Martin could not see. No one really can see around Payne. So you really can't blame Radar Martin for that one. But Michael Stevens with a rake to the eyes. And Michael's choking Payne over the second rope there. We've seen a little bit more of aggressiveness out of the one Black Widow here at ringside. More vocality out of her than we've seen here in recent weeks. And certainly that has something to do with the attack that happened after the final match 2 weeks ago here in Locust Grove.
Absolutely. We've always said she's silent but deadly, but I wouldn't put anything past her.
No, that's true. We've seen in different times, we've seen her get involved in some matchups on the bad side of things for Payne and Bill the Butcher. And we're seeing her be an advocate here at ringside, to use a term that's not positive in the wrestling world, I guess. Advocate is what Paul Heyman is. But Michael Stevens measuring Payne here at ringside. Swivel of the hips and a double axe handle right across the back of Payne's head. They have the big man down. Michael Stevens trying to drag Payne into the center of the ring. A little bit silly there. Going for a cover. Radar Martin in position for a two count. And 2.5 there from Payne. Payne just able to get the shoulder up at the 2.5 mark. Michael Stevens getting Payne back up to a vertical base. Yeah, this isn't going to happen either. Payne with a reversal into the ropes, going for the backdrop.
Oh.
Michael Stevens with a kick to the chest and a shake of the hips again. Payne with a goozle. Stevens into the barricade there, right there. Huge slam. This is going to be all she wrote here.
Got him.
Three count there, and Payne is victorious.
I believe he has a smile on his face under that mask.
Yes, absolutely.